Morning, everybody. Up again, and this time around, I thought I'd try something totally and completely different here. Dark Souls Remastered. This is supposed to be one of the most popular games of all time, and it's also supposed to be one of the most difficult. So I just kind of curious to see why everybody likes this game so much. But I am having a problem with this. First and foremost, for pretty much all these games, I can't play them full screen. I have to have them in windowed mode. Reason being is I need to be able to freely switch between windows back and forth. If it was in full screen mode, there's this whole song and dance, for lack of a better word, that'll go through. The whole screen will go black for a few seconds before switching over to another window, which I don't want, because usually when that happens, there's a chance that my computer will completely black out and I'll have to restart it. Let me look at something else. Come on. Okay, just made a little adjustment there. But let me get my, but like usual, I'm in the middle of setting up here. But like I was saying a few moments ago, so because of that, Dark Souls also has another issue where I can't resize the window on it. You can't make it bigger, smaller, etc. So I'm having to sit here and do a screen resolution Olympics, having to make my computer desktop bigger just to make this fit in there and all that, and it was just an ongoing struggle. I think I got it to where I want it. But right now, the issue that I might be having is if the entire lower part of the game might be completely cut off because of my taskbar. And again, I need to have my taskbar up at all times because I like to be able to switch between windows. Failing that, I might end up having to just kill this game completely and just write it off and go get a refund from Steam off of this. I paid about $40 for it, so I don't want to have to eat it. And if that does happen, I'll probably end up playing probably Torchlight 2, since I've been taking that game up again. Also, like I said, this is my very, 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 very first time playing this game. I've watched a speed run on this once or twice. I've watched a few gameplay videos on it too, so I kind of have somewhat of an idea as to what to do. Let me look at some of these other games. Chat box is up. And probably another little nitpick. I haven't delved further into this game at all. But if I cannot use both my keyboard and mouse, and my controller, I'm probably just gonna write the game off. That's kind of another little requirement. I need to be able to use both my controller and this. And that being said, let me unplug it so I can make it cordless. And then let me get my fan on the floor, because this is where I'm gonna have my controller, down here at the bottom by the floor. And so having my fan down there at the floor, it helps keep my hands cool and dry. Let me test my Twitch app real quick. Make sure it's actually working. Okay, app works. Okay, controller works. I don't want any, I don't want any vibration. But like I said earlier, display mode has to be windowed. I can't have it full screen. Because, again, I need to be able to switch between my windows freely. I have my OBS up, my streaming software. I have to be able to check on that from time to time. Make sure that my, most importantly, make sure that my mic is still running. My mic still works, because it's got a habit of just suddenly cutting out on me. I also have my Twitch information on again, in case I might need to let any viewers know that I might be doing something else. I might be doing something important within the game. I like being able to update my Twitch info at all times. I also have my notepad up in case I need to write down anything important that needs to go on my blog post. So I need to be able to switch between windows freely. Okay, so where is the bow that he's wielding? Damn, that looks pretty cool. STD bomb. Like throwing a syphilis cocktail or something.
Good Lord.
Like a baby commando or something. None of these characters can have facial hair, huh? Okay, here we go. Hormones. I'm looking for the facial hair. If any.
In the age of ancients, the world was unformed, shrouded by fog. A land of gray crags, arch trees, and everlasting dragons. But then there was fire. And with fire came disparity. Heat and cold. Life and death. And of course, light and dark. Then, from the dark, they came and found the souls of lords within the flame.
All right, I'm gonna try something here.
Nito, the first of the dead.
Nope, didn't work. I was trying to hide the taskbar.
The Witch of Izalith and her Daughters of Chaos. Gwyn, the Lord of Sunlight, and his faithful knights. And the furtive pygmy.
I'm hoping this isn't lagging my stream too much.
With the strength of lords, they challenged the dragons. Gwyn's mighty bolts peeled apart their stone skins. The witches weaved great firestorms. Nito unleashed a miasma of death and disease. Seath, the scales betrayed his own, and the dragons were no more.
And everything was a clusterfuck.
Thus began the Age of Fire. But soon the flames will fade, and only dark will remain. Even now, there are only embers, and man sees not light, but only endless nights. And amongst the living are seen carriers of the accursed dark side.
Well, so far, I'm still able to see all the subtitles, so that's good. But on the downside, though, streaming this is taking up at least half of my CPU. The game itself is taking up between 20 to 30% of it. Oh, now it's up to 35. And my graphics, it's using up about half of my graphics card. So I have a feeling that I'm probably going to have to turn some of these settings down. If that still doesn't work, then that's probably going to be another reason why I'm going to have to write this game off. I knew that one. Oh, I forgot this game has a stamina meter. Whoops. I don't know what I did there. Attack. So, how do you jump? So I'm guessing that you can't jump in this game. But yeah, so far this is looking to be a resource hog. I'm gonna have to look up and see what these terms mean, because it's not giving me any tooltips. So it's gonna be a few minutes. I'll start with ambient occlusion. It's the one I actually remember. Okay, so I'll go ahead and turn that off. All it does is it toggles the lighting quality on objects. It makes them look realistic. Motion blur, I ain't gonna need that. Anti-aliasing, I'll go ahead and turn that off. Depth of field, I'll just turn them all off. Vertical sync, I'll leave that the way it is. There's block and parry. So then what happened to my weapon? Okay, apparently I still have it equipped, but so then how do you put stuff on your thingy down here in the lower left? So I had it back here. That wasn't it. Whoops. So I'm guessing you can't jump in this game. It's kind of lagging a bit. Oh, we got emotes. It's got some range to it. There it is. It's like a really slow charge up. Still don't work. Lock onto the target, please. Man, everything's just so freaking slow. I'm missing here? Like, should I be fully geared up or something before? Because I don't think just wearing monk robes and a broken sword is really cutting it. And no, I don't expect to kill the boss in only one single hit, but doing 3 points of damage isn't doing anything to him. Thank you. Oh, shoot, that's, now, let me do this. Type this down. Okay, I gotta do something about attuning my magic. Yeah. Feels like I'm missing something, and that heal spell isn't working. Supposed to be a way to two-hand your weapon. I forgot how to two-hand the weapon. doesn't seem to work. Lose humanity and souls and return to bonfire. No. Change order. Well, I would think it'd be in change equipment. There's supposed to be a way to switch from one-handed to two-handed mode. I mean, I'm not even gonna... I don't think that's gonna stop his big old hammer. Must be missing something. I can't see me fighting this big, huge monster with just the claws on my back and a busted sword. Yeah, I don't get this. Well, it's the only other thing I can think of. Okay, and I'm guessing I'm heading all the way back to start. Law says you're supposed to attune magic. okay, I don't have to double hit. As long as I'm moving in a direction and hitting circle, I'll dive in that direction. Just barely caught me. He does that one twice. Nope. Man, look at the minuscule amount of damage it does. The only other thing I could think of is his tail is a weakness. Yeah, I don't get it. There is something I'm missing there. I mean, I get the game is supposed to be difficult, but if this is what their idea of difficult is, then there's... Hell, I probably have to go on a YouTube video to see what the hell everybody else is doing. Oh, yeah. Thanks, Kataro. It's like I was saying a few moments ago. It's like I must be missing something here. It's like all I'm doing is just a measly 2 points of damage to him. I do remember me having something called an Estus flask, but as I'm still trying to figure out what the controls do, I accidentally used them all. I got a heal spell, but I can't use it. Yeah, I'm on vacation this week, but here, I know what. Activate internet for this game if you want messages from players. Kinda iffy on that. Cause as far as I know, going offline also turns PvP on or something like that. Yeah, it won't let me use it. Okay, it's online right now. Oh, there it is. I just had to push triangle. I get hit anyway. Where? Can we dash, please? Okay. So, in other words, I wasn't meant to fight that battle. Okay. Thanks, Kataro. Change equipment. Okay. Got an upgrade. Nope. There we go. Okay, so you do have to actually aim with a shield then. So, this isn't like Bastion then, where, you put the shield up, he automatically aims it at the nearest monster. So, there's no way to pause this game, is there? Okay, I'm gonna assume that the game auto-saved. Real quick, I'm gonna run to the bathroom real fast, and then while I'm up, I'm gonna get me something to eat as well. So, I'll be back in a few. Okay. I'm gonna have me a peanut butter sandwich and a Reese's peanut butter tree. Ragdoll. Okay, apparently not.
You're no Holland, right? Thank goodness. I'm done for, I'm afraid. I'll die soon. Then lose my sanity. I wish to ask something of you. You and I, we both undead. Hear me out, will you? Regrettably, I have failed in my mission. But perhaps you can keep the torch lit. There is an old saying in my family. Thou who art undead art chosen. And thine exodus from the undead asylum maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient lords. When thou ringeth the bell of awakening, of the undead, thou shalt know. Well, now you know. And I can die with hope.
Okay, yeah, I kind of noticed that.
Oh, one more thing. Here, take this. An Estus flask. An undead favorite. Oh, and this. Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death. So go now, and thank you.
Okay. Was that message again? Oh. Where's my shield? That's what I'm doing. Oh, speaking of that. Okay, so I'm not covering it up then. It's not doing it. Yeah, I can't seem to do it with y'all. Yeah, see, it's not working. There we go. I just couldn't use that heal spell until now. That wasn't it. Where do I get my shield at? Always had it. Okay. No wonder I couldn't find it. And I'm guessing that shade that was following me was basically a tutorial shade. Okay. That's kind of good, but it is lagging a bit. It does lag at times, and it does use up most of my resources, so... I guess he can jump up there. Oh. I don't recall me ever going this way before. All right, screw that. Oh, he came from out of nowhere. Hit, please. So, you made it sound like there was a bonfire here. door on here somewhere. Can't see. Oh, they blocked the door. Two for one. Bad call. I was trying to backstep, but all this guy's attacks have a delay. So I guess one other complaint I probably have would be its unresponsiveness, although really isn't much I can do about that. But two for one. I kind of want to know if there's a... way to lock the door. You would have thought that there'd be a bonfire here. Well, that's a critical hit one. Otherwise, failing this, I'll probably just break off and probably play something else. I'm thinking Torchlight 2. It was a game I haven't played in a very long time, or I've recently gotten back into it. Got a lock on him. Waste that was. I'm a retard. Wrong button. Come on. Wait. Alright. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and, I'm gonna switch games. I'm probably gonna switch over to Torchlight 2. Again, it was a game I haven't played. It was a game I haven't played in a long time, and I only recently got back into it. So it's gonna be about 5-10 minutes or so to get all the stuff changed over. But otherwise, this game here is pretty much a keeper. So definitely worth the $40 I paid for it. I mean, but if it streams on here just fine, then that's a good thing. So, got lucky this time around. But anyway, it's going to be a few minutes, and it'll be Torchlight 2.